Manic, how many times do I have to tell you not to eat all the Halloween candy? What are we going to do if there's none left by the time all the little boys and girls get here?
Hello.
Well, would you look at that? It seems as though one of our guests have arrived. What's your name, little boy or girl?
Hi, my name is Justin.
That's a nice name. My name is Knuckles the Echidna, and this is Manic.
All right.
And who is this little kid you have with you? Is this your little brother?
I guess.
He's absolutely adorable. Can he say hello to us too?
Hello.
Damn, isn't that the cutest shit you have ever seen? Well, the fact that you're here, it must mean that you're here to listen to a scary story, right?
Yes.
Then go ahead and pull up a couple chairs, 'cause we're diving right into this bitch. Once upon a time, there existed a small town called Sleepy Hollow. Now, on the outside it may look like any ordinary town, but deep down, this small town held a dark, dark secret. It is a legend that is told to little boys and girls to scare them from going outside at night. And tonight, bitches, I'm going to tell this legend to you. Legend has it that on Halloween night, when the clock strikes 12, the bridge to the Sleepy Hollow Cemetery will be enveloped by a thick fog. If you stand on the bridge long enough, you will eventually hear the sound of a bicycle bell. When you hear it, you should leave the bridge immediately, because that is a sign that he is coming. Who is he, you ask? Well, as you have probably already guessed by now, they call him the Pantsless Bike Rider. They call him that because he is completely naked and rides a bicycle. When you see him riding up through the fog, all you can do is haul ass, or he is going to get you. Nobody knows for sure what the Pantsless Bike Rider is after, but it is believed by many that he is looking for the one in town with the biggest ass. And wouldn't you know it, a young man by the name of Sonic the Hedgehog had just moved into town. And his ass was pretty damn huge. He moved here with his siblings, Sonia and Manic. Their mother Alina, and his uncle Chuck. Of course, they all knew the stories before coming here, but the house they were moving into was just so cheap, they couldn't pass it up. They moved here only a week before Halloween, and began to settle in their new home. Nothing was out of the ordinary. Until one night, the three hedgehog siblings were in the living room, decorating for Halloween. A scary movie was on TV, and they were eating candy and pies and other fall treats. Sonia turned her head to Sonic and said,
"Sonic, have you heard the spooky tale of the Pantsless Bike Rider?"
Sonic responded with,
"Of course I do, bitch. Everyone all over town is talking about it right now. Apparently he shows up on the haunted bridge every Halloween, or some shit."
Sonic asked Sonia why she brought up the topic. Surely she wasn't interested in actually going, right? Just then, Manic interrupted.
"Hey, tonight is Halloween. We should go to the haunted bridge at midnight and see if he shows up. I just got my driver's license, so we can drive down there when it gets dark."
Manic seemed excited. So excited, in fact, that he was about to shit his fucking pants. Sonic and Sonia looked at each other, as if waiting for the other to accept Manic on the offer. But could this be dangerous? What if one of them got hurt? No, they will be fine. After all, it's only a fucking story. There is no way the Pantsless Bike Rider is real. Sonic and Sonia, again, looked each other seductively in the eyes, as if wordlessly saying, "Yeah, bitch, we doing this." If the Pantsless Bike Rider really is naked like the legend says, there is no way they are going to miss a peek at seeing that ghostly forbidden ass. And so, when the clock struck midnight, the three drove down to the haunted bridge of Sleepy Hollow. Would the Pantsless Bike Rider really show up? None of them knew for sure, but they were willing to wait all night, if they had to. They parked the car on the side of the road, and made their way over to the bridge. It sure was spooky, but there was no Pantsless Bike Rider. There wasn't even fog like the story said there would be. Then, Manic poked Sonic on the shoulder.
"Hey bro, I dare you to go out there and stand in the middle of the bridge,"
Manic said. Sonic looked at the bridge, then back to Manic.
"Why don't you do it? Or are you too scared? Are you a poopy baby bitch, or something?"
Manic laughed.
"Come on my blue bro, you know what the legend says. The Pantsless Bike Rider will only go after the one with the biggest ass. And we all know how big your ass is."
Sonia agreed. Sonic blushed at this. Sonia and Manic were right. Sonic's butt was big. Far bigger than the average person's. Sonic's massive butt would be ideal eye candy for the pantsless bike rider.
Fine, I'll do it, but when nothing happens, we're going to get a chili dog from Quick Trip. And you're paying?
Sonic slowly but surely made his way out to the center of the bridge. When he made it, he looked back at Manic and Sonia. Sonia was laughing and Manic looked pissed because he now owed Sonic one fat, juicy chili dog. Sonic winked at his green bro and spanked his big blue butt cheeks. He spanked his own ass so hard that not only his ass jiggled, but the whole bridge beneath him jiggled as well.
Okay guys, I'm coming back.
Sonic called out. But before he could take another step, fog started to appear out of nowhere. Just as the tail of the pantsless bike rider said it would.
Holy shit,
Manic cried. Manic and Sonia ran straight back into the van and drove off, leaving Sonic behind on the bridge.
Sonia, Manic, don't leave me, you guys are overreacting, it's just fog. You don't seriously think the pantsless bike rider is real, do you? Manic, what about my chili dog? Manic, you're a fucking bitch.
But in reality, Sonic was the only bitch here. He was absolutely terrified of what was going on. He was so scared he didn't even have the courage to run. He just stood there in fear, surrounded by darkness and fog.
This has to be some kind of joke. I bet Manic and Sonia put Mom up to this. Or Uncle Chuck. They're all playing a prank on me.
Sonic thought to himself, but he knew he was just making shit up. He knew the pantsless bike rider was going to show up any minute. He had to get out of here, now, or else he will become the pantsless bike rider's bitch. Then, through the mist and the fog, Sonic heard something. It sounded almost like a bell on a bicycle. It rang over and over again, and it got closer each time. Wait, how did the tail go again? The fog will roll and after that, you will hear a bicycle bell ringing. That is a sign that the pantsless bike rider is nearby. At that point, you better haul ass, or you'll become the pantsless bike rider's personal bitch. Oh no, that's right. Sonic needed to run. He needed to get away before it was too late. But it was too late. Just as Sonic turned to run, somebody rode by on a bicycle and grabbed Sonic. It was none other than the pantsless bike rider. Here to claim Sonic the Hedgehog, the boy with the big ass, for himself. Sonic was dragged along the wooden planks of the bridge, unable to break free of this ghostly figure's grasp. And then, just as quick as he appeared, the pantsless bike rider disappeared into the fog, taking Sonic with him. Sonic was never seen or heard from again. And that, boys and girls, is why you should never go to the pantsless bike rider's bridge on Halloween night. The end. So little boy or girl, what did you think of the story? I hope it wasn't too scary for you.
That was awesome, dude!
Ha 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 ha. Well, if you enjoyed it that much, be sure to come back tomorrow to hear another one of our spooky tales.
Don't just sit there watching me, lying alone, trying hard not to sleep. Your shadows like to watch me dream and mess with me and our memories.